King Edward VI College, Centre number 20570, Theatre Studies, Unit 4, the performance of Virtually Free. My name is Rebecca Wallace, my candidate number is 1367, and I play Jo.
My name is Isaac Mill, my candidate number is 0892, and I play Nick and Jo's father.
My name is Olivia Salmond, my candidate number is 1153, and I play Margot and stepmother.
My name is Bethany Fletcher-Jones, my candidate number is 0421, and I play Sophie.
My name is Alice Grove, my candidate number is 0496, and I play Ro.
My name is Jenny Ray Hadley, my candidate number is 0510, and I play Emma and Jo's mother.
My name is Naomi Shaw, my candidate number is 1197, and I play T.
Never-ending adventure.
Have that.
Well, we're in a new expansion. Why don't we explore some new areas? I can gather more supplies.
Well, I mean, we could, but like, we can go back to camp and get it first.
Yeah, alright then.
If it's the quest you wanted, you'll come to the right place. If there's anything you need, then just look for my charming little face. Do you want to explore or find new lands, chase dragons or dreams? It's all in your hands. You won't look to me like you want a war, a fight to the death to settle the score. Have your battle with friends or foe. What are you waiting for? You better go.
Well, who are we fighting this time then?
Statistically speaking, we should...
Oh my god!
It's so ridiculous!
What
is this? They've got a fire up. Hello?
Guys, this is Margot. She's my little sister.
What is she doing here?
Well, I thought I could have... Maybe...
Look. Margot wants to join the team.
What would she add to the group?
Well, she's a good fighter. She's just past level 5 and she's already half
and
level
10. And she's saying that I'm level 14.
Come on! Can I miss anything? Come there and get...
What?
You go.
Yeah.
Okay. Who are you?
Oh, hi, I'm Margot.
This counts for swallows only, and I'll explain. I'm level 14. I can fight and I can farm. And I killed three dragons. Tig is level 13 and she's a massive craftsman. Jo is level 15 and I can control the game. And Sophie is level 24.
25.
Whatever. 25. And she's advanced in tactics and strategy. I think we've got everything that we need. Come back with a lot more time.
Well, I'm really good at stealth. I can steal things. And then
I've got everything that we need.
Guys, can we just talk about this? She may not add anything to the group, but she's certainly not going to do any harm.
I think a member who adds no value is pointless.
But she seems really nice.
Nice won't win us any quests.
Yeah, I guess so. I haven't got any more hats.
Increasing the number of members in the group by one useless member will decrease our average success rate by 23%, meaning it will have a negative impact on the whole team.
Then don't take her on any quests, but let her train as part of the group.
Look, Nick, it's nothing personal. It's just... Wait till she has more experience.
Guys, come on.
It won't work.
It's not
no,
a big deal.
No, Nick. She's not joining. Why the hell just come down?
Basically, Nick, it's not happening.
Fine. If she doesn't stay, I don't stay.
Well... If we subtract Nick's average success rate from the team's overall total, then the difference can be proportionately accounted for by the rest of the team's contribution.
Does that mean that Nick's leaving?
No, don't be stupid.
I'll do what you want.
What?
We heard Sophie. It wouldn't matter if you left.
You seriously all want me to leave?
No, of course.
Yes! If you're going to choose someone else over us, just leave.
If you're going to choose someone else over us, then just leave.
Fine.
Fine.
If you need me again, I'll be right here.
Come on. I've got a walk thing about. Yes.
Right, come on, we've got some tidying up to do.
Nick, can I show you something first?
Can you show me later? We both have a lot of work
to
do.
Please, I want to show you now.
Margot. I'm busy. If you're not old enough to help tidy up your own camp, just log on.
Okay, then I guess I'll just tidy up.
All right. Do you want to do some training?
Yes!
Fighting or farming?
Fighting!
How did I guess? Okay, you're in the forest and you're looking in your inventory and you turn around and there's a creature right behind you.
Nick, that's just you!
Yeah, you can have to use your imagination.
Nick, I'm not doing it unless you do it properly.
Promise not to laugh.
I won't, come on.
All right then. You turn around and there's a creature right behind you. Okay, it's 5 meters away, it's got head armor and no bonuses. What do you do?
Fire an arrow at it.
Where?
Its body.
Exactly.
No!
But it's not dead yet. It runs to get the high ground advantage.
Yeah.
So what do you do now?
Well, I can't fire an arrow because I've only got one. I could run away, but then I wouldn't get my arrow back.
Good.
It's too dangerous just to hit it, so I'll charge
Awesome, but with what?
An axe and a sword!
That's the one.
But it manages to dodge despite its injury and it's coming up and it's ready to hit you. So what do you do now?
Distract it!
With
this.
You're not going to have time to run over there. Wait, what is this?
Well, it's this box I found. When you open it, it flashes a load of colours. So I thought I could just distract it and then I could...
Did you take this from the Swallow's camp?
Well, they wouldn't let me in, would they? I wanted to show them I was good at stealth and scheming things. Some kind of magical discovery, I think.
It's not some kind of magical discovery. But this is the Swallow's control box. It keeps all their quests and inventories on it. It's only flashing colours because we're not allowed to use it.
I'll take it back, I promise it!
You're not taking it anywhere. You can't just run into a camp of enemies, and especially not you, you're not experienced enough. Look, they're looking for a target for a war, and that's probably going to be us, so we need a plan. You go collect some food, and I'll just hide this over here for the time being.
If we're actually going to be successful in this quest, we're going to need to make sure we have an absolutely solid plan.
I see.
Right, there are multiple camps. There are multiple camps that we can attack, but this one is the closest, it's 10 minutes away.
10 minutes? It won't take that long.
Better not. As I was saying, we need to make sure that if we're going to attack this one, which is off in this direction, we have enough supplies and ammo to defend us if they know we're coming.
But do we?
Well, if we don't know, checking the inventory is T's job. Okay?
Go and check then!
We just don't have time.
What about
that one's even further. Do you even know how to read
what?
It?
Anyway,
if we don't have enough supplies, then
it's not there.
I think we have time to get there before this group realise that we're going to attack them. But if they realise before we leave, we might...
Where's the control box?
What?
I said, where is it?
I don't know. I haven't seen it since we were last online.
It's got to be around here somewhere. We'll look for it. How can you move?
The only explanation is someone's stolen it.
Margot, I knew you couldn't trust her.
She did say she liked stealing things.
She did say she liked stealing things.
But she seems so nice. She seems so nice.
You know what we should do? Play a minigame we got 4 levels ago. We should declare the war on Nick and Margot.
War?
Yes, the war.
They are close enough, it would be possible.
I guess, if it's
possible. So let's do it! It's okay, guys, I'm sure I can find it somewhere. Tay, are you in or not?
What Nick did was wrong.
You wouldn't be selfish and leave us like he did, would you?
No, of course not.
Come on, then.
Good.
It is with deepest regret that I inform you of the Swallow's decision to declare war upon the Amazons. This is resulting in Nick leaving the Amazons to join his sister. The rules of the game are as follows. The Swallows must retrieve their Swallows and Amazons control box, while the Amazons must retrieve their Swallows and Amazons pack. Your war begins now.
Right, we need to come up with a plan to win this.
We should defend our camp.
Yeah, but we've got to get something from their camp too. Just defending isn't going to work.
What we can do then? What if we all hide and then when we come into our camp, jump out and scare
them? Don't be so stupid. We need our control box back to win. Playing hide and seek isn't an efficient tactic, team.
Look, they outnumber us, so we're not going to be able to defend against them.
So they'll enter our camp, right? Because they know we'll be there.
We should enter their camp. They know we outnumber them, so won't be there to defend it.
We've only two of them in the camp. They know they can't win.
So, we send a search party to their camp.
Exactly. We need to make sure what they want to get isn't inside our camp.
I'll take it.
No, you can't defend yourself. I'll take it.
So, what are we going to do with this camp?
I'll take it now.
Happy?
Happy.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Right, let's go.
I am not letting us lose this war. We need to show those Amazons what we can do without Nick holding us back.
But we've never done anything about him before.
Well, he's not
coming back, so we'd better get used to it.
He isn't coming back, so we'll just have to get used to it.
Sophie, plan?
Well, their camp is further away, so it'll take longer, but they have no idea we're coming.
So will we.
It's almost guaranteed.
Jo, did you find anything in that new expansion?
With Nick? Yes, with him.
Who else? What were you doing with him?
Nothing, just exploring. Look, there's not much there, only food, no supplies, and really we can't get anything anyway, not without the control box.
Wait, so does that mean that Nick can get onto it?
You can't access a control box unless you're part of the team. Nick hasn't got a chance.
Yeah, but neither can we. So what do we have?
Well, look, I know I said we should do combat, but we might be better with stealth.
Like I can see how you
Tim, do you actually want to win?
Mum, I'm playing this. Anyway, so they don't really have much in their camp as far as I know, and Nick was really excited about the new expansion, so they might go there and try and get some supplies.
Ooh, then their camp will be empty, so we can go in, get in the control box without having to hurt anyone.
No one would leave their camp empty, even the level one would leave the guard.
No, but Nick would, wouldn't he? There's only two of them, and he seems obsessed with that little sister. So I bet his camp is unguarded.
I guess there's a possibility.
Still, do we really want to risk getting in a proper fight?
Oh, come on, this control box is there. It'll be easy to get. We go in.
Now?
Yeah, right now. We haven't got this time to waste.
Are we sure offensive tactics are the best option here?
We're a higher level than them. It doesn't matter if we get into a fight.
I'm not so sure.
Yeah, no.
Think about it.
Right. Right, sorry, okay. Real life stuff. I've got to go. I'll be back in a couple of minutes. Don't do anything stupid while I'm gone.
That's...
I hope she's quick. We don't have time for this.
We won't have to hurt Nick, will we?
We will if he gets in our way. He deserves it.
Don't worry, T. I'm sure he won't be there.
Finally, we need to make a decision.
I agree with Ro. We're going to their camp now.
What?
Look, if Nick and Margo are there, then they're just going to have to face the consequences. T, do we have a weapon?
Axe.
Okay, bring it with you.
No.
Let's go.
Don't think we'll need that.
Look, if Nick's there, then he'll just have to deal with what he gets for leaving us. Come on, let's go.
Now you're thinking like a winner. Come on then, let's go.
Right, you over there. T, just stay on.
Well, Sophie, you're good with strategy. Where would you hide it?
I wouldn't hide it here. I'd take it with me where they can't get to it.
Yeah, well, it's not that smart. Neither of them are.
Well, you know best where we put it.
Okay. Okay, so they have it with them. That just means we're going to have to ambush them. We'll just have to do it now.
That's not what we meant, Jo.
Well, it's what I meant, so. T, can you come over here, please?
Yeah.
Give me the axe.
No,
give me Jo, the axe.
Think about what you're doing.
We need to take back control. We have a weapon. We have the element of surprise. We can win this war today.
Fed up with letting other people tell us what we should do.
I'm fed up of letting other people tell us what we should do.
Well, what would you have us do?
I would say here is a distraction. T would sneak up on them and grab the
control
box.
No, we need to leave. We can think of a new tactic.
Take the axe in case we get in a fight. Take it. Sophie, you go up there. T, you get her there and Ro, you deal with her. I'll stay here.
Come on.
I really hope I get onto Les.
Jo, this isn't your camp. What are you doing here?
I'm not letting you take the control box.
I want to tell you about that, actually.
Really? About what?
About the way you left the swallows. To be honest, I think you left the way you left.
I know that was an ambush, but I do want to see the deer.
Well, me and Margaret aren't interested. You're going to get your reward.
You will listen to me.
Listen to me!
Fine. What's it about, the war?
Among other things. Look, the thing is, Nick, I want you to come back to the Swallows. The way you left it, it's not been the same about you, and I know the others would be grieving and they would tell you, but they missed you. We missed you.
You know I can't do that. I'm part of Margot's team now.
Yeah, and next time we go to war, we're going to win, just the two of us.
Exactly. Right.
Well, the thing is, I think you were a bit rash when you left the Swallows. I mean, no offence, Margot, but they're not exactly a high level, and we were all a lot higher level than you.
Look, invite me. She's good enough to join the team. She can join the team.
Well, you're a bit biased. I mean, it's not like she's trustworthy, is it?
What's that supposed to mean?
Well, I mean, she was in our camp for all the pirates, and then she went and stole our control box.
If that's what this is about, just let me explain.
For goodness sake, Nick, she stole it.
It isn't her fault. I
she
can explain.
She stole it. She took it. It had everything, and she took it.
Joe.
For goodness sake, Nick, if you can't
Joe.
See that, then you're an idiot.
You stop fighting over me. It wasn't
calm down.
I didn't do anything.
It's her chance, Nick. Joe.
Joe. Calm down. Look at what you are doing, and calm down! Margo, just run! Get out of here! Joe, come on! Joe, you're still here!
It's not your fault. Of course it isn't your fault. It's no one's fault.
to be alone for a while, if that's okay, please.
I'd like to come in to talk, please.
Don't mind deciding to speak to me while I'm here.
Well, actually, I wanted to speak to you first, so. Don't you have a responsibility?
Don't you go making out like it's
my fault! Don't look themselves!
They've only been this way since you walked away from us. Do you know what? I think you should go.
Listen. I didn't just come here to speak about that. I've got something else I want to tell you and Joe together.
No. I've heard enough from you.
You are not stopping me from doing this. I'm going to leave for a moment, and then I'm going to come back, and I'm going to speak to both you and Joe in here together.
Don't you hurt me. I don't want you in my house. If you're going to choose someone else over us, then just leave.
You do not have a choice in this. I will be back in a minute. Do you understand?
I'll be back in a couple minutes.
Joe, good to see you. Right. This is Claire, and she's my new girlfriend.
What?
We've known each other as friends for a while now, and things changed, and now we're a couple.
Her? You know her?
Your father introduced me once before. She did say she liked stealing things, but she seemed so nice.
Look, I know this might come as a surprise, and I'm aware it's difficult.
You haven't got a clue.
But I'm telling you, you need to listen to me.
Fed up of letting other people tell us what we should do.
Look, we've known each other for a while now, and I thought now was the time to introduce the two most important people in my life.
How long's a while?
Well, a few months or so.
You mean you left us for her?
No, I haven't left
she
you,
Joe. She stole you!
No.
She stole you and now you're treating me like a child. Mom, I can't. Listen
Come on.
To me. You no. need to get out of my house!
Look, this isn't just your house. Just because I don't live here doesn't mean I don't have a place here. But Joe is my child, and I have every right to speak and to them when I want to. Look, you may not care for me, and that's fine. I don't care about that, because I don't care for you. But I do care for my child, and I'm not letting you get in the way of that. You mean nothing to me, but Joe means everything. So I would like to speak to my child alone now, please. Look, I'm sorry, Joe, but it's just that we care so much about you.
She took you!
It's not her fault I left. It's just
Just what?
Please don't fight over me, Joey. It wasn't him. He didn't
How
ever do
you
anything.
How say that? He's been spending all his time with you, and you've been treating us like idiots.
No, Joe.
I bet you've been trying to get him to leave for ages now. You're just thinking about yourself, and both just thinking about yourselves. And now you think you understand how that affects us.
Joe.
Affects me, but you don't understand. And you're being selfish and manipulative, and I never want to see you again.
Why would you do that? You had no right to do that. You had no right to do that! You think you can just walk into any relationship and change it to suit you? What makes you think that you can just do what you want? You are not the only one in control. Other people get a say, and it is not all about you. You think you can just hide yourself away from the world and come out when it suits you? Well, you can't. And you know what? I don't want to talk.
I'm not the one who has an issue with control. I'm not the one who can't control their emotions enough to have the decency to stay with those who need them. We need you. Maybe we still even do, but we needed you when you were strong and supportive and kind, not when you're arrogant.
Why? Because you can't look after yourselves.
You know that's not true. We make a better team than you two ever could.
Well, maybe, yeah. You can look after yourself in a game. But what does that really mean?
What's that supposed to mean?
Hiding yourself away in a game. Not showing up anywhere. Not letting me see or talk to you. What's that word?
Look. It's a game. That's the whole point. There's no rules. I can just go in whenever and be who I want. And there's no rules. And I have control over what happens to me.
Okay. But I'm sorry for leaving you for her. And I'm sorry that maybe I don't fully appreciate what you're going through. But even if it's just a game, you can't
can't spend every hour of every day there.
Why not?
Because, aside from all this, you've got people to be spending time with and things to be achieving, and even though that may be hard, and maybe I don't understand that, but if you let it get the better of you, then everything will just disintegrate around you and then something like that will happen.
I do all that stuff. And then when I get home, I want to relax. Do something fun, what I want to do.
I know that, Jo. I know that. I'm not saying you can't do that, but you've got to do all the other stuff too.
I'm not trying to hurt you. I'm not trying to abandon you. I do just honestly want to help you. I'll give you some time here.
Go and spend some time on your own in the game, that's okay. Explore it and enjoy it. Then come off the game and see what you've got there. Explore it and enjoy it.
A strong feeling deriving from one's circumstance, mood, or relationship with others. I don't believe you've understood. In order for one to understand your emotions, it is important for you to explain your emotions.
Well, you don't have a clue. You don't even have them.
I'm not quite sure. However, I'm not quite comfortable with your term.
Well, sorry, I'm angry. Sad. Probably a whole bunch of stuff. To be quite honest, right now I just want to pretend I have a disease.
All participants are free to leave the game anytime they choose.
I don't want to leave.
I'll do.
Sorry.
Yeah, I mean, you've got to apologise to, matey.
It's all there, out there. The ones you've been pushing away. And they just want you to log out.
But it's easier here. It's so hard out there. It's a distraction.
Reality ain't supposed to be easy.
It's supposed to have, like, challenges and, like, be like a quest. You can't go hiding behind a screen forever. There's a whole world out there. A real life world. With real life stuff. And you can, like, touch it and smell it and fall in love with it in there.
Maybe I should leave.
All participants are free to leave the game anytime they choose. Please select the exit door if you wish to leave the game.
But what if you're, you know, lonely without me here? I can keep you company. What if I can't do it out there? What if it's too hard? What if I mess everything up with my family and it's all my fault and I just...
Don't think like that. It ain't your fault. Of course it ain't your fault. It ain't anybody's fault. Listen, all your ability lies in that controller, where you can choose to, like, leave and enter the game. But right now, you're taking advantage of it. I think you should just log out. It's all in your hands, Joe. When you need me